तो दोस्तों स्वागत है आपके अपने YouTube चैनल में वंस अगेन। मेरा नाम है प्रेम और आप देख रहे हैं अवर वाइज स्टॉक्स की स्पेशल इंटरव्यू सीरीज, जिसमें कि हम आपको मिलाने वाले हैं कम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम्स के टॉपर, जैसे कि IIT जैम हो गया या फिर MBA के लिए कैट हो गया, ठीक है, जिन्होंने 99% हासिल करी है और उन्होंने अपने ड्रीम कॉलेज तक पहुँचे हैं। तो आज हम उनसे उनकी जर्नी के बारे में जानेंगे और इस वीडियो में सीखेंगे कि किस तरीके से हम और आप भी अपने ड्रीम कॉलेज, अपने ड्रीम जॉब तक पहुँच सकते हैं। दोस्तों आज जो हमारे साथ इंटरव्यू सेशन में आए हैं, उन्होंने कैट 2022 दिसंबर में ही रिसेंटली 99% और एग्जैक्टली 99.64% हासिल करी है और वो भी अपने कॉलेज के थर्ड ईयर में ही। तो फॉर दोज हु डोंट नो, आई वुड लाइक टू मेक इट क्लियर दैट कैट एग्जाम इज गिवन बाय अप्रॉक्सिमेटली 2 लाख स्टूडेंट्स ईच ईयर एंड फ्रॉम विच ओनली 2000 सीट्स आर अवेलेबल फॉर द टॉप मैनेजमेंट इंस्टीट्यूट। सो यू कैन सी हाउ कॉम्पिटेटिव दिस एग्जाम इज एंड आई एम हैप्पी टू टेल यू दैट आज हमारे साथ गरिमा गर्ग हैं, जिन्होंने कैट में 99% हासिल करके अपने सारे टॉप के IIMs और FMS और भी सारे जो भी टॉप मैनेजमेंट इंस्टीट्यूट होते हैं वो सारे कन्वर्ट करे हैं। तो आज हम उनसे इनकी जर्नी के बारे में जानेंगे। तो गरिमा गर्ग आप बताइए, आपको कैसा लग रहा है, मतलब एग्जाम क्लियर करके आपकी जो जर्नी थी, आपने बहुत मेहनत करी होगी, मतलब फर्स्ट ईयर सेकेंड ईयर से आप इसकी तैयारी कर रहे हो और फाइनली अब आपका एग्जाम निकल गया है, तो आप ऑब्वियसली बहुत खुश होंगे और अब आपको बहुत एक्साइटमेंट भी होगी कि अब आपको FMS जाने का मौका मिलेगा, IIM जाने का मौका मिलेगा, जो कि हम जानेंगे इस वीडियो में कि इन्होंने कहाँ जा रहे हैं, इन्होंने कहाँ पर एडमिशन लिया। तो बताइए आप।
So it's a great journey when you see your dreams turning into reality. The things you have worked for like 1.5 years and now they are turning into reality. It's a great, great feeling. And yes, so I can't express, I don't know how to express it. I have been dreaming of joining a B school since forever, as far as I can remember. So yes, now that I have finally cleared CAT or and I have cleared the wet PI processes, I would be joining FMS now. Although I converted other IIMs as well, like IIM Calcutta, IIM Kozhikode and IIM Indore, but after talking to my mentors and my parents and family, I have decided to join FMS, Faculty of Management Studies.
दोस्तों इसे कहते हैं real happiness. Like हम तो बस मुस्कुरा रहे हैं, लेकिन एहसास यही कर सकती है इस जर्नी से और वहाँ तक पहुँचने का। सो गरिमा अब आप थोड़ा सा इंट्रोड्यूस कर दीजिए कि आप कहाँ से और कौन सा कोर्स किस कॉलेज से परस्यू कर रहे हैं, इंट्रोड्यूस।
सो बेसिकली आई एम गरिमा गर्ग एंड आई बिलोंग टू अ स्मॉल टाउन इन हरियाणा विच इज़ कॉल्ड सिवानी। आई कम्प्लीटेड माई स्कूलिंग फ्रॉम सिवानी इटसेल्फ एंड पोस्ट दैट आई डिसाइडेड टू परस्यू माई बैचलर्स ऑफ कॉमर्स। आई एम बेसिकली परस्यूइंग बीकॉम प्रोग्राम फ्रॉम किरोड़ीमल कॉलेज, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ दिल्ली। ड्यूरिंग माई कॉलेज आई डिड अ फ्यू इंटर्नशिप्स इन डिफरेंट डोमेन्स। अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट आई वॉज पार्ट ऑफ अ फ्यू सोसाइटीज एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस ऑफ द कॉलेज इटसेल्फ। सो दैट्स प्रीटी मच अबाउट माई प्रोफाइल। सो आई एम बेसिकली अ फ्रेशर हु वुड बी गोइंग इन टू बी।
तो अब हम सीधा जानते हैं आपकी जर्नी के बारे में। तो सबसे पहले आप ये बताइए कि आपने जो कैट की तैयारी कब स्टार्ट करी थी, लाइक फ्रॉम द वेरी बिगिनिंग आपने कब इसके बारे में सोचना और उसके बारे में स्टार्ट किया था कि मैं MBA करूँगी और इसके लिए ये चीज़ें चाहिए।
सो व्हेन आई डिसाइडेड टू परस्यू माई BCom, आई डिसाइडेड दैट आफ्टर माई BCom आई हैव टू डू माई मास्टर्स एंड आई वुड बी परस्यूइंग माई MBA राइट आफ्टर माई कॉलेज। सो आई स्टार्टेड प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर कैट फ्रॉम माई सेकेंड ईयर इटसेल्फ। आई जॉइंड अ कोचिंग फ्रॉम इन ऑगस्ट 2021 and so it was somewhere around 15 months. So I took coaching for 15 months from an institute. I cannot name an institute. I started taking coaching from August 2021 and obviously we had our exam in November 2022. So it was somewhere around 14 to 15 months. And post that I enrolled, once the results of CAT came, I enrolled myself for wet PI coaching. And yeah, so that's about the journey.
तो आपने जो कोचिंग मतलब अगस्त में स्टार्ट करी थी, तो उससे पहले आपके जब आपने कैट का मॉक या फिर पेपर देखा हो तो आपका कौन सा सेक्शन डिफिकल्ट था, जैसे कि इन कैट दे रहा 3 sections क्वांट्स DILR एंड VRC, लाइक VRC इज इंग्लिश, क्वांट्स इज लॉजिकल रीजनिंग एंड देर इज इंग्लिश एंड मैथ्स इज क्वांट्स। सो 3 sections, तो आपका तीनों में हाउ मच यूर स्ट्रेंथ एंड वीकनेस इन विच सेक्शन।
Okay, so coming from a non-maths background, I had studied maths till class 10th only. So quant was something that I was really worried about because I wasn't really good with quants and mathematics stuff. So that's where I thought that I would have to work a lot. Apart from that, VRC section and DILR were my strengths. In fact, DILR was my strength. Even in CAT 2022, I scored 99.91% in DILR, which was the highest among the 3 sections. So yes, I prepared most for the quant. DILR I was already good at it, so I used to solve a few puzzles every day, which helped me keep my momentum going. And apart from that, for VRC I used to read passages, I used to read newspapers. so that I am good with reading, I am good with retaining the content I am going through. So yes, the quant was the challenging one. Apart from that, both the sections were something I was good at from the beginning, so I could nail them.
So when you find that your DILR is the most strongest, so you mostly work on this section or you taking all the sections equally?
So I used to give equal time to all the sections, because as far as I have heard from the seniors that no matter at what section you are good at, you do not know about the D-Day. CAT is very, very unpredictable exam, and anything can happen at the last day. You might score best in your weakest section and score the lowest in your strongest section. So I decided I would give equal time to all the three sections. So for DILR, since I was already comfortable with the subject, I used to solve medium level or advanced level questions so that I can work accordingly. For quant, obviously I had to start from scratch, because there were concepts like algebra or geometry I wasn't really good at, or I wasn't really comfortable with. So I started studying about them. So I used to focus a lot on quants. And yeah, for VRC, as I mentioned earlier, I mostly focused on reading so that I'm good with retaining and comprehending the stuff, and that worked pretty fine for me.
So आपने जो VRC की जो reading थी वो आप पहले से करते आ रहे थे, या फिर you started reading and made it a habit after when you started preparing for CAT?
See, it's ideal कि आप पहले से ही start कर दे reading. That's very very ideal if you are good with reading starting से, so it really helps. But yes, I wasn't really into reading, so once I started that started my coaching, so then I decided कि I would have to read daily. So I had this routine that for 1 hour I used to dedicate completely to reading, half an hour to my newspapers and half an hour to Aeon essays or essays from any other sources. So yeah, that's how my 1 hour was completely dedicated to reading every particular day.
My next question would be कि आपने हर एक section की तैयारी कैसे करी, मतलब कि आपका quants था तो जब आपका coaching में आपका syllabus चल रहा होगा तो आपका क्या strategy रहती थी, या जिस तरीके से करवाते थे उनका क्या system रहता था, आप क्या follow करते थे, किस routine से आपकी पढ़ाई थी जब तक आपका syllabus complete कर रहे थे?
Okay, so there are two ways I can explain, but let's go by the timeline and the sections. So basically, I'll start with quant. So as I mentioned earlier as well, that I was weak with quants. What I used to do is ki coaching mein jaise chal raha hai, jo chapter unhone cover karwa diya, I used to solve the questions from the booklets they have provided, and then a few extra questions from YouTube or Google. There are ample resources available on internet, so I used to use all of them so that I can widen my horizon as much as I can. So yes, for quant, I usually followed this strategy that whatever chapter has been covered in the class, I would come to home and I would solve all the questions, search for another resources, solve them, and practice. So yeah, obviously practice and consistency is the key to to clear this exam. So yes, I used to practice, I used to solve the same question twice or thrice so that I know, okay, what is the logic behind solving this question. For the first 3 months, I was following this only in quant, that whatever has been covered, come back to home and solve that. After that, I started taking a few mocks so that I can understand what kind of questions I need to work on more, and what kind of questions what is the time I need to spend on different set of questions. So once I started taking mocks, I realized that I am able to solve enough number of questions that would guarantee me a good percentile in quant, and that's when I realized it's time to focus more on mocks and less on the booklet stuff. So after 3 months, we were almost done with our half of the syllabus. So for that half part, I used to take sectionals. There are ample of sectionals available from the coaching and otherwise as well. So I would take sectionals, revise them, then I would take mocks. So yeah, for quant, this was the process. We completed our syllabus till June, and after June I used to take mocks only and solve any extra questions. I didn't spend any extra time on booklet. Now that I have already solved it 2 times, I didn't feel like I need to solve it again. Instead, I would practice different set of questions so that my mind is prepared to face anything that I haven't seen before. Coming to DILR section, again, I used to solve 2 to 3 puzzles every day, 2 to 3 sets every day from August. So DILR is one section where coaching cannot really help you. It's just the practice that will make you, get a hold of this section. So it's just the practice, solve as many sets as you can. That was my strategy, and that was something I heard from seniors. So I remember solving around 800 plus sets for DILR. स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 2 to 3 सेट्स पर डे टू समटाइम्स इवन 8 to 10 सेट्स पर डे एज वेल बिकॉज आई रियली लव सॉल्विंग डीएलआर. सो इन द इनिशियल डेज माई स्ट्रैटेजी वॉज कि आई नीड टू सॉल्व दिस सेट नो मैटर हाउ मच टाइम आई एम टेकिंग. आफ्टर 4 to 5 मंथ्स व्हेन आई रियलाइज कि नाउ आई एम एबल टू क्रैक व्हाट द सेक्शन इज आस्किंग मी टू डू और व्हाट द सेट इज आस्किंग मी टू डू आई स्टार्टेड फोकसिंग ऑन टाइम एज वेल दैट आई एम एबल टू सॉल्व अ सेट विद इन 15 to 20 मिनट्स एंड देन कम डाउन टू 10 मिनट्स. सो फॉर DLR अगेन I solved sets, I took sectionals, I took
modes. Yeah. Garima, aap mujhe bataiye, DILR mein syllabus like is not properly mentioned.
Syllabus is vast here.
So aapne matlab kahan se set karte the, aap kaun sa choose karte the, kaun sa aapko practice karne daily basis pe?
So again for that the ideal advice is ki go through 10 years ke CAT ke previous papers so that you get an idea ki what CAT is trying to test you. This is something you should analyze after every 2 months because before attending your CAT ki coaching you will have to see ki okay what are the different sections, what kind of questions you are asking, do you really need coaching or can you do it by yourself. But after 2 months you will again have to go through all the previous year papers because after 2 months you have gone through the syllabus, right? So you have an idea now that you will go back to the papers and you will see, you will realize ki okay this is the syllabus, these kind of questions you will be able to identify the things. So this is what I used to do. After every 2 months I would go back to previous year papers to understand what CAT is trying to test me, what kind of questions I'll have to do. Again, as I mentioned earlier, there are ample of resources available. You'll get booklets from you'll get a lot of puzzles from your coaching. Then I used to follow up YouTube channels. So I used to get sets out of there as well. Then again, from mocks, from sections, you can get a lot of sets.
So जैसा कि आपने बताया कि यू यूज टू फोकस ऑन पी वाई क्यूज मोस्टली. सो आपको कोचिंग मटीरियल बता दो, आप उससे अपने पी वाई क्यूज में यू मोर एम्फेसिस मोर देन द मटीरियल और इक्वली या फिर फर्स्ट यू सॉल्व द कोचिंग मटीरियल देन द रिलेटेड पी वाई क्यूज यू सॉल्व.
सो इट डिपेंडेड कि वॉट आई वॉज लर्निंग, वॉट वॉज माई प्रोग्रेस. फॉर फ्यू सेक्शंस आई यूज टू डू पी वाई क्यूज साइमल्टेनियसली but sometimes so what I exactly did is I do PYQ simultaneously. Once I'm done with my coaching material I started doing PYQ so that I get hold of the concepts.
So first you saw
completed the coaching material and then I went to PYQ. So PYQs were part of, see what I used to do is ki once you are done with your syllabus you do not have to go back to your booklets, you do not have to go back to the concepts, you have to just practice them. And for practicing you need to take a lot of sections, you need to take a lot of mocks. So I used to give PYQs as mocks only.
So that was the strategy for DILR you have to use. So now we move to the VR section, how we can tackle this. So please, what's your strategy here?
Okay, so for VRC, as I mentioned that I used to devote my 1 hour to reading itself. I would read newspapers, editorials for half an hour, and for next half an hour I would read AON essays or Scientific American essays. I made sure that I am reading from diverse areas so that I am not stuck to one particular genre as such, and I am comfortable with any kind of passage that it comes. So be it biology, be it geography, be it chemistry, be it economics, whatever genre it is, I could tackle that. So I used to read from diverse areas. I started reading novels as well. Although I didn't really get a lot of time to read them, but I made sure that at least 10 to 15 pages I am reading on daily basis so that I am comfortable with all the subjects. Apart from that, for VRC again I would solve reading comprehensions 4 RCs per day, that was my thing. Apart from that, for VA verbal ability I mainly focused on para jumbles because that's something I really liked and I felt I am good at. So I would solve para jumbles. Again, para jumbles, it would depend upon mainly on my mood but not on strategy. Sometimes I would solve just 10 para jumbles, sometimes I would end up solving 25 or even 30-35 questions. So it would depend ki if I am able to solve, if I am enjoying that. There is no hard and fast rule how many you want to solve. It's all about getting to know how to do it. Once it clicks ki okay that is the passage or that is how it is going to work, you will get it. And again, if you are good at reading, it would help you in para jumbles as well. So VRC section is completely about reading. Read as much as you can. That was my personal strategy.
सो आपने यहाँ पे बहुत कुछ बता दिया है, तो लेकिन इसमें मैं जानना चाहूँगा कि जैसे आपने बताया फर्स्ट यू रीड न्यूज़पेपर, यू आल्सो रीड नॉवल्स एंड यू आल्सो डेली प्रैक्टिस ऑफ आरसीज एंड देन वीए सेक्शंस ऑफ पैरा जंबल्स डिफरेंट, सो आपने कब से मतलब कि आपकी रूटीन दिन में आप कितना घंटा देते थे इंग्लिश को, और एक वीक में आप मतलब कैसे आपने स्टार्ट करी कि आप रीडिंग करना स्टार्ट करा, फिर आपने नॉवल्स उसमें ऐड किया होगा, मतलब पूरी प्रोसेस क्या थी, करने में तो बहुत कुछ है, तो करेंगे कैसे हम?
सो देर आर नो डेडिकेटेड आर्स कि मैं इतने आर्स ही पढ़ूंगी, इट वुड अगेन डिपेंड कि कितना टाइम मिल रहा है, बिकॉज आई हैड माई कॉलेज एज वेल, आई हैड माई सोसाइटीज वर्क, आई हैड माई इंटर्नशिप्स एज वेल, सो इट वॉज यूजली लाइक आई हैड सर्टन टारगेट्स फिक्स फॉर एवरी डे, लाइक फॉर वी आर सी आई यूज टू की 4 RCs पर डे एंड अ फ्यू क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम वी ए, सो दैट वॉज माई टारगेट. नाउ इट माइट टेक एन आर, इट माइट टेक 30 minutes सम डे, आई हैड नो फिक्स टाइम, बट आई वुड मेक श्योर दैट आई एम सॉल्विंग 4 RCs एंड अ फ्यू क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम वी ए. Again for DILR in the starting months I would solve 2 to 3 puzzles, but by the end I would say July, August, I would solve 8 puzzles a day. So for quants I used to divide my time between arithmetic and algebra. So since I liked doing arithmetic and I was good at it, I decided to focus more time on arithmetic itself. So that I am able to tackle even the most difficult questions there, and for algebra I made sure that I am able to tackle very easy or easy level questions or at times at medium level questions. So that's how I kept my preparation. I would identify the questions as very easy, easy, medium, difficult and very difficult. For arithmetic I used to solve all kind of questions, and for algebra I used to limit myself to medium itself, because I knew that algebra is something I would really struggle with. So that's how I had divided my syllabus. So for quant, again arithmetic I would solve 30 to 40 questions per day, and for algebra I would see the concepts and solve 20 to 25 questions per day. So sometimes I would complete the entire thing in 4 hours, sometimes it would take me 6 to 8 hours as well. I never had dedicated time, but by the end months, I would say August onwards, I used to spend around, it usually took me 6 to 8 hours to complete everything, because I used to take mocks as well. I used to take 2 mocks per week. So you take mocks are for 2 hours and then you also have to analyze them. So it was generally 6 to 8 hours.
So मतलब जब आपका syllabus complete हो गया था तो आप सब कुछ थोड़ा थोड़ा पढ़ ही रहे थे, जैसे आपने arithmetic.
हाँ, simultaneously मैं थोड़ा थोड़ा पढ़ रही थी, so that I am used to all the things, because CAT is about consistency and practice. Practice as much as you can. And the best part was that I really loved doing it. It wasn't something ki, even though there are people who would just solve mocks and get very, very good percentile, and that does happen. So, but I really liked solving questions. I really enjoyed the process. So I would solve questions. I would take mocks. Sometimes it happened ki, I couldn't score very good marks in one mock. So I would end up giving 2 or 3 mocks in a day. So because
2 plus 2 plus 2, 6 hours.
Yeah, so because, but I like doing it, so the fact that I like doing it made it easier for me, because the process of CAT is very, very draining. It breaks you at times, you just want to give up at a lot of point. A lot of my friends did give up in between while they were having very, very nice mock scores, but they did give up because they couldn't handle the pressure. What helped me handle the pressure was the fact that I was enjoying it. I really liked solving the DILR. I really liked reading passages. And of course, I had the support from my friends, again, as I mentioned. So we were a group, like my friends were my real support system. They would hype me up every time I would get good marks. They would give me a shoulder to cry on when I would not get good marks. So, yes.
मुझे लगता है आपकी कोचिंग में आप सारे दोस्त वगैरह साथ में थे और एक साथ तैयारी.
यस, सो वी वर अबाउट लाइक 5 to 7 पीपल. दे आर माय कॉलेज फ्रेंड्स, दे वर माय कोचिंग फ्रेंड्स, लाइक दे आर माय एंटायर दिल्ली एक्सपीरियंस, टू बी वेरी फ्रैंक. दे आर द ओनली पीपल आई नो इन दिल्ली. सो यस, दैट वॉज रियली हेल्पफुल. सराउंड, मतलब दैट इज समथिंग आई रियलाइज, दैट इफ यू सराउंड योर सेल्फ विद द पीपल हु आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर द सेम एग्जाम, दैट रियली हेल्प्स. बिकॉज वैन आई वुड कॉल दैम, ओके कितना पढ़ लिया यार, एंड दे वुड से कि यार मैंने 2 chapters कर लिए, एंड देन यू दैट इट वुड हिट यू कि ओ शिट, दे हैव ऑलरेडी कम्प्लीटेड 2 chapters एंड यू हैवंट इवन स्टार्टेड. सो दैट विल पंप यू अप टू डू इट. वी हैड दिस थिंग कि ओके दैट वुड बी वेरी पर्सनल स्टफ, बट येस वी हैड दिस थिंग दैट हुएवर स्कोर्स द लोवेस्ट इन अ मॉक विल बी giving party to everybody, that he would be sponsoring डिनर फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस, एवरीबडी हैज दिस थिंग कि मेरे को लोवेस्ट नहीं लाने हैं. सो दैट वॉज ऑल्सो वन थिंग कि मोटिवेट करता था, एक कंपेटिटिव फैक्टर था. देर वॉज अ हेल्दी कॉम्पिटिशन अमंग ऑल ऑफ अस.
सो दैट्स मेक द डिफरेंस. आई गॉट टू नो नाउ. सो मुझे जानना है जो थोड़ी बहुत प्रॉब्लम्स आती है जर्नी में, लाइक आपने जब सिलेबस करना स्टार्ट किया तो आप पहले तो बताइए, आप कोचिंग के पेस के साथ चल रहे थे या आपने कुछ अलग से एक्स्ट्रा में चल रहे थे, या उससे कब पीछे हो गए थे आप कभी?
सो आई हैड अ बेनिफिट ऑफ स्टार्टिंग अर्ली कैट,
या स्टार्टेड इन द
अगस्त 2021. सो आई हैड द बेनिफिट ऑफ स्टार्टिंग अर्ली. नॉर्मली 9 मंथ्स आर मोर देन इनफ फॉर कैट प्रिपरेशन. सो स्टार्टिंग अर्ली एक्चुअली गेव मी एन एडवांटेज बिकॉज आई कुड स्टडी विद माई कोचिंग. We complete, as I mentioned earlier, we completed our syllabus in June itself, so I had enough time for my mocks and for sectionals. So I used to keep up my pace with coaching only. Whatever chapters they have covered in the class, I would come back to home and do them, practice the content around that. But yes, I didn't stick myself to the coaching content only. I used to explore other content, other coaching's content from my friends. I used to study a lot from YouTube, from other Google resources, which I think you would be mentioning in the group description, right? So yes, I used to explore different resources. I didn't stick myself to particular set of questions because what I understood is that CAT is unpredictable. There can be questions from any
stuff. So this problem also, I think, hits you.
Yeah, so it happens, but again, it depends upon how well do you practice. See, once you have covered one chapter, and see, if you have covered chapter number one, and now you are doing chapter number six with the coaching, you can start revising as well. So yes, I used to do it with the coaching, but once I felt ki okay, we have covered enough chapters, so simultaneously I would start revising as well. So, and once you have revised it twice or thrice, I believe, things start getting stuck, and again you are taking sections, you are taking mocks, so these are the things that would come up. And again, here is again a benefit of friends group. Your friends would be, there would happen that you are at chapter number 5 and your friends are at chapter number 3 or chapter number 2, so they would be giving your doubts to you, so us hisab se bhi aapka revise ho jata hai bahut zyada.
दोस्तों, दिस वॉज द ओवरऑल स्ट्रेटेजी आपको किस तरीके से पढ़ना है और सिलेबस को कवर करना है. हम जब आपका मॉक्स और सिलेबस हो गया था, तो आप जब आपने मॉक्स देने स्टार्ट किया, तो पहले तो आप मेरे को बताइए कि आपने मॉक्स स्टार्टिंग से देना शुरू कर दिए थे, लाइक आधा सिलेबस या 1/4 ऑफ सिलेबस हुआ था उसके बाद से फुल सिलेबस मॉक टेस्ट देना शुरू कर दिए थे, या फिर आपने थोड़ा सिलेबस होने के बाद किए थे? और सेक्शनल्स तो आप दे ही रहे थे चैप्टर वाइज, जो सारा आपने दिया था ना.
सो आई स्टार्टेड टेकिंग मॉक्स इन जनवरी. From Jan to March, it was like ki 2 mocks in a month because us time tak syllabus bahut zyada nahi hua tha. Then from April onwards, because we were almost done with the syllabus, I used to take 1 mock per week. So that's how it worked. And from July onwards, I started doing like 2 mocks per week. And there were times, by the time we reached to September, October, I used to take 1 mock in 2 days. And in November beginning, I would take 1 mock every day.
And what was your score from beginning to the start? How it fluctuates?
My marks in mocks were very fluctuating. It started with a very good percentile, like 98+ percentile. Then there were times that I would barely manage to even clear the sectional cutoffs. And the fact that I had my lowest mock marks in October, that was almost, there was just one more month left to my the actual CAT exam, and I had my lowest marks in October, so that really hurts. But okay, that's the part of the process. You would see, mocks are just for your practice. You should not really be focusing on how much marks you are getting or how much percentile you are getting. What you need to take out of every mock is that okay, where did it go wrong. Right, you need to analyze ki okay, if you couldn't clear quant ka sectional cutoff, why you couldn't clear, what are the topics you are really lacking at. So if you find out ki quant nahi ho raha, so you start focusing more on quant. If you feel like ki okay, you are scoring good enough marks in VARC, so you would work less on VARC and more on quant. So that's how we would decide our time.
Next question would be like, how much you involved in the college societies, and did you come regularly in the college? How much is your attendance, and how you manage coaching societies and then college also?
With respect to college, I would come to attend only important sessions so that I could focus more on my CAT. I would obviously attend important lectures, but I didn't really attend all the lectures. Apart from that, yes, I was involved in societies. I was heading one of the societies in my second year. I was doing, I was part of an NGO as well. So it was pretty much manageable for me. I used to dedicate specific hours to my college and to societies. So yeah, ho jata hai manage if you try to. It's completely on to you ki aap kaise karte ho. What are your interest? Matlab, I would not say ki cat ki wajah se maine fun nahi kiya hai. I had all the things. I would go out with my friends. I would attend college. I would participate in societies activities. I would participate in competitions. So these are the things which are pretty much manageable. Again, it was because of I started preparing early. So it gave me ample time to explore other things as well. Kyunki mera syllabus on time chal raha tha. I didn't have to force things on myself.
So like when there used to be events of the society, then that day you have to be active for the whole day. So you used to come in college and that day you didn't, I think, not much
for
study instance, for the
So I had this thing for myself, study for 5 days and have fun for next 2 days. And those 2 days are not necessarily be have to be Saturday or Sunday. They do not have to be weekends only. I had this thing ki 5 din acche se padho, fir 2 din sirf fun karo.
I mean, haan. Padhai nahi karte kya?
2 din nahi. Matlab, I had this thing ki 5 din itne acche se padho ki yaar tum 2 din fir tumhe padhne ki zarurat na pade. Because I did prioritize my mental health during this process because bahut draining process hota hai and I had to prioritize my mental health. So I used to study for 5 days and I used to have fun for 2 days. Which again gave me time to cover up the syllabus if I couldn't for 1 day. So as you mentioned ki event or society ka ya event or college mein to tum pure din nahi pad pa rahe ho. To fir ek din ho gaya na mera wo fun wala.
To us din ka jo backlog
ho jata hai. Us din ka jo backlog hoga main bache hue 2 din mein cover up kar lungi. To matlab that gave me time as well ki agar tumhara matlab as I mentioned ki mere dedicated hours nahi the but I used to have targets. कि मेरे को इतना पढ़ना और आफ्टर 5 days इफ आई रियलाइज कि हाँ इतना टारगेट मेरा कंप्लीट हो गया था बट ये रह गया तो आई वुड यूज दोज 2 days टू कंप्लीट दैट एंड हैव फन एज वेल फन वाज कांस्टेंट
ओके सो दैट्स हाउ यू कैन डू टाइम मैनेजमेंट दैट इज फर्स्ट थिंग यू डोंट हैव टू कम कॉलेज रेगुलरली यू कैन कम ऑन द इंपॉर्टेंट डेज लाइक व्हेन योर टेस्ट इज देयर और योर एग्जाम्स आर कमिंग सो एट दैट टाइम इज ओनली नेसेसरी थिंग एज यू सेड Later you have for the one day you can give yourself off after rigorous study of 6 or 5 days. So you can give yourself some time for relax and then re-energize to attack the next day. So my next question is how much is the importance of joining societies and what internships and extracurricular things you have done? And as we know that for CAT it is important that your profile is good, you must have done something different from the college. Apart right. from getting good marks in college and also doing some other things, क्या चाहते हैं इनसे ठीक है तो फिर आप बताइए कि आपने क्या क्या करा था और
सो वेन इट कम्स टू फ्रेशर्स यू नो सिंस आई एम अ फ्रेशर ऑफ कोर्स एंड आई हैव टॉक्ड टू अ लॉट ऑफ वर्क पीपल विद वर्क एक्सपीरियंस सो सिंस वी आर फ्रेशर्स वी नीड टू हैव गुड प्रोफाइल सो दैट वी कैन स्पीक सर्टेन थिंग्स इन आर इंटरव्यू योर इंटरव्यू लाइक आफ्टर यू आर ओके यू आर डन विद कैट बट देर आर बैट PI एज वेल वट वुड यू सी इन योर PI It cannot revolve just around your academics. If you have certain extracurriculars with you, that adds a lot of weightage because I was part of a society, as I mentioned in my second year. I did a few internships. So that was a great point because these are the things I have actually invested on. I could speak about them endlessly. Just ask me anything about my society. I was outreach and public relations at Enactus KNC. So ask me anything about my department and I can go on and talk about it for 24 hours, even more than that. So these are the things I had really done and I could speak about them. I could justify my work in the interview. So I would highly recommend work on profile building. I think a lot of you know coaching centers do conduct these seminars, how to build your profile. So it's good to have 1 to 2 good internships in your resume and one position of responsibility in your resume. So and that again it does not only help you in your personal interview but also add to your personality development and character development.
So another thing I want to know that you can do like you are in the PR head public relations and if someone is creative head there are different departments so is it necessary that there is a must be a relation of like you are in the head but you are applying for finance in
no there is no relation between that being a head defines that states particularly that you have leadership qualities you can lead a team of 60 plus people you can communicate you can share things, you can plan things. So these are the soft, you learn soft skills from these society experiences.
तो इसमें ये जरूरी नहीं होता कि आप मतलब वो आगे ये स्कैनिंग ये डाउट नहीं पूछते कि आपने इसमें कर रहा है और आप इसमें अप्लाई कर रहे हैं। तो ये बहुत अच्छी बात जानने को मिली कि आप बस कुछ भी करते रहिए जो मौका मिला आपको करने का और फिर इसके बाद आप अपने
ग्रैब द अपॉर्चुनिटीज बट ग्रैब द राइट अपॉर्चुनिटी डू नॉट डू एनीथिंग दैट कम्स योर वे डिसाइड व्हाट विल ऐड वैल्यू टू यू
मतलब जिसमें आपको इम्प्रूव करना हो जिससे आपकी सॉफ्ट स्किल्स कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स इंग्लिश स्किल्स और सब कुछ बढ़ पाए। So as we are talking about the GDP and extracurricular, so I would like to know what after CAT exactly the process, like you have said there are personal interviews, there are two, I think I have listened, you have to write essays for the, and then your purpose of joining some college asked for this. So what are the different criteria and things asked in IIMs, FMS in which you have
applied? So basically after your CAT, you have your VAT PI round. So some PI is constant, you will have PI in every B school. So certain B schools conduct VAT, certain B schools conduct extempore, like for FMS and for IIM Indore specifically we have extempore, and for IIM Shillong we have GD, but yeah, we have some other thing as well, like GD, extempore or VAT, one out of these three things, and then we have personal interview. So
what is VAT and what is extempore?
VAT is like writing ability test. They will be giving you a topic on which you will have to write. You will be given somewhere around 15 to 20 minutes and you will have to write on that topic.
Random topic?
Yeah, it would be a random topic. And extempore, again, that's the same thing, that you would be given a topic on the spot and you will have to speak on it.
What are the different types of questions you have been asked in the personal interviews? And is there, they have asked the questions related to your subjects like which you are studying, because I have listened that they are also asking your college subjects which you are studying. And what extra they ask, like general knowledge questions?
Okay, so interviews are basically divided into three things. Number one, they ask you HR questions. HR questions include everything about you, who you are as a person. Apart from that, whatever learnings you have gained out of all the things you have done in your college, be it extracurricular activities or anything. The second thing is academics. So whatever subjects you have studied in your class, in your bachelor's or master's, if you have done that, like I was basically asked a lot of academic questions, questions from accounts, questions from finance. Having said that, I come from BCom background, so they would ask you academic questions. And the third is general awareness. They could pick up any topic. It could be political, it could be geographical, or anything that's happening around you at this point, at the point you are giving your interview. So they will ask you questions on general awareness, what are your views. They do not really want to know the facts, but your opinions on different things.
And what if we don't know about what they are question asked of the current affairs?
It's okay, no one can expect you to know 100% of the things. You can politely mention then, okay, I'm not aware of this thing, but I know this thing, something related to that topic, you can tell them. And obviously, again, the interviewer do not expect you to know everything.
So basically, आप क्या चेक करते हैं कि
दे चेक हाउ वेल डू यू कम्युनिकेट हाउ स्ट्रॉन्ग योर ओपिनियंस आर एंड हाउ वेल डू यू नो व्हाट्स हैपनिंग अराउंड यू एंड योर सब्जेक्ट्स
सो दैट्स हाउ यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर फॉर द जीडीपी आप ये बताइए कि आपने जैसे कैट की तैयारी मतलब एग्जाम निकाला था तो उसके बाद आपने इसकी तैयारी आपकी कोचिंग में हो गई थी या उसके अलावा आपने कहीं से भी इसकी
सो आई टुक अ सेपरेट कोचिंग फॉर पीआई
पर्सनल इंटरव्यूज के लिए सेपरेट बाकी सब like written essays of
skill. Yeah, they all are covered in VAT PI coaching itself.
Okay. My last question would be that everyone knows when you're preparing for such competitive exam, there are times when you feel that I have to give up or I think I cannot reach that 99th percentile club. So at that time, how you overcome your failures or whenever you feel like in the start you have said that आपके दोस्त थे जो उन्होंने स्कोर वेरी गुड इन द स्टार्टिंग बट देन दे लेफ्ट प्रिपरेशन इन द मिडल एंड एज अ रिजल्ट दे कैन नॉट गेट टू देयर ड्रीम कॉलेज सो आपने अपने किस तरीके से आपको मेंटेन रखा और कैसे डिसिप्लिन रहते थे आपका क्या सिस्टम होता था मतलब
या सी फॉर कैट कंसिस्टेंसी इज द की यू हैव टू कीप योरसेल्फ मोटिवेटेड नो मैटर व्हाट आई हैड माय लोवेस्ट पॉइंट्स वेयर आई फेल्ट लाइक आई नीड टू गिव अप बट It is your family, it is your friends that help you overcome that. You know, rant as much as you can. If you have something in your mind, let other people around you know that. Because once vent out, once it is out of your mind, once it is out of your heart, you will feel lighter and you would be able to go ahead with that. So as I mentioned, I used to keep these things that I didn't stay away from any particular thing, that I didn't leave social media, I didn't leave hanging out with my friends. I did everything. So I had a proper balance. I maintained a proper balance between the things so that I am not overwhelmed with one particular thing. So yeah, that was my motivation. मतलब motivation तो क्या कहेंगे but
that तो इसके अलावा भी अगर बात करें तो जैसे कि जर्नी में आपने बताया कि आप खुद को मोटिवेटेड रखती थी और रहते, तो स्टार्टिंग में हो सकता है कि आप ज़्यादा सोशल मीडिया, आप किसी न किसी चीज़ को मतलब किसी न किसी बैड हैबिट होती है जिसको कि आप जर्नी के दौरान आप उसको कट करते हो, ऐसा हो ही नहीं सकता यार।
नहीं मतलब आई हैड माई सोशल मीडिया एंड अदर थिंग्स इन कंट्रोल फ्रॉम द स्टार्टिंग इटसेल्फ। आई वुड नॉट, आई यूज सोशल मीडिया एंड सोशल मीडिया इज नॉट अ डिस्ट्रैक्शन पर से, इट डिपेंड्स ऑन हाउ आर यू यूजिंग इट, how much you are using it and how are you using it. It's, I feel it's good to talk to your friends, it's good to, you know, just post random stuff on your whatever social media account it is. So it's great. I think social media is distraction only when you let it to be.
So you have to be balanced in everything, like using social media and spending time with friends also, and then society is everything recovered. It's like brilliant, and that's how you can achieve your dream college as yet done. So dosto, that's for the video. I hope you like the video, and I would like to thank Garima for spending their time and giving us their valuable knowledge on CAT preparation, how we can start our preparation, how to tackle our difficulties, where to spend time, everything I have covered in this video. I hope you get the proper guidance. Any question if you have, you can pin me in the comment section. I would like to answer you all, and that's it for the video, and wonderful video. So at last, I would like to ask any message, any advice, any opinion, any quote you like and you want to share among us to motivate us, and whatever you like, please share with our audience.
I would just like to say, be consistent with your preparation. You will have your highs, you will have your lows, but they are just temporary. Keep yourself motivated and stay focused. Try to be around the people who are preparing for the same exam. That will really help you keep pace with your syllabus as well as motivate you whenever you need that. So yes, keep practicing, and I hope you all clear the exam. All the best.
So I hope next time aap video mein is taraf hoenge aur mere ko bhi mauka milega aap sab ka interview lene ka. So is video ke liye itna hi dosto. Agar video pasand aayi ho, aur obviously pasand aayi hogi, itni mehnat se banayi hai hum aapke liye, from KMC to FMS. So दोस्तों, अब आप इस वीडियो के एंड तक पहुंच ही चुके हो, सो प्लीज डोंट फॉरगेट टू लाइक एंड सब्सक्राइब अवर चैनल सो दैट आई कैन मेक मोर सच वैल्यूएबल वीडियोस, एंड आई होप दिस वीडियो विल डेफिनेटली हेल्प यू इन योर कैट प्रिपरेशन. एनी डाउट, एनी क्वेश्चंस यू हैव, यू कैन आस्क मी इन द कमेंट, एंड देयर इज आई हैव पिंड द यूट्यूब चैनल्स व्हिच यू यूज्ड इन ड्यूरिंग द कैट प्रिपरेशन. यू कैन रेफर टू दोज चैनल्स. And also, if you have any questions, you can comment or you can reach me out on my social media accounts. All the links are given in the description and also in the comment box pinned. So thank you very much for watching my video. Best of luck for your exam.